Janet.
That's my girl. To change the Super Bowl performance was actually made after the final rehearsal. MTV, CBS, the NFL had no knowledge of this whatsoever, and unfortunately, the whole thing went wrong in the end. I am really sorry if I offended anyone. That was truly not my intention.
It certainly wasn't easy being Janet in the media firestorm that followed.
Did you realize that you had such a powerful breast?
That's the embarrassing thing. Did you know that 90 million people saw your boob? That was embarrassing. Then to see it blown up as big as a
We love giving y'all something to talk about.
Yes, it certainly was something to talk about when Justin Timberlake removed part of Janet's costume, exposing her right breast to 90 million people.
Are you upset with Justin Timberlake?
I'm not going to answer that. I think Justin and I probably maybe need to talk. I know we talked before all of that happened, and we've been friends, and, you know, we called in to see how each other was doing with the whole situation, and we haven't spoken since other things have happened since then, so.
Because you still remain friends.
At some point, he and I need to talk.
That pause said it all. Actor Jamie Foxx, meanwhile, wasn't as subtle.
I didn't appreciate when Justin Timberlake went on and he sissied out and he said, hey, you know, I didn't know anything about it. I think that was not cool, because if that's really your friend and if it's really about art, then you say, hey, we made just a small mistake.
But despite public apologies from both Janet and Justin, it was Miss Jackson who took most of the heat.
You know, of course, it's like another female takes the heat for, you know, doing something racier or risque. But of course, you know, it's the whole double standard. But I mean, my God, it's, you know, they've said their piece about it. They've apologized and enough already.
The FCC was inundated with thousands of complaints and slapped 20 CBS-owned TV stations with fines totaling $550,000. And CBS demanded an on-air apology from Janet and Justin. But Janet refused. Justin seemed to escape the scandal unscathed, going on to win a Grammy the following week and book 4 movies, while Janet's career hit a wall when, after the scandal, Lena Horne reportedly no longer wanted her to portray her in a film.
It's her life story that's been portrayed, and she has the right to choose.
Janet's family and friends, though, chose to stand by her side.
All of my family called me, gave me words of encouragement to keep my head up and to stay strong.
Y'all lucky I ain't pull out something. Lucky I ain't flash something.
This is sick. Protection. It's time to taste.
Wanna get like you're looking to pull. Shove it till you're shaking the floor. Pop it like you're popping a cool.
This is funky. This real.
I'm very excited. I'm grateful. And I'm deeply honored to receive this award. I cherish it not only because it comes from my own people, but because it comes from the heart and soul of the music that shaped my life and my career. I'm amazed to say that I've been in this business for 30 years, and I'm proud to say that I've endured. That endurance is my heritage as a woman, and especially a black woman. I'm convinced that we black women possess a special, indestructible strength that allows us to not only get down, but to get up, to get through, and to get over. I truly thank God for that strength, and I thank you for your belief in me. I love you too. You've been there for me during the good times as well as the bad, and you've lifted me up with your love. Your loving support has always been a great source of comfort, especially in these last few weeks. So, thank you so much for this precious honor. I take it to heart. I hold all of you close to my heart, and I intend to use this award as further motivation to represent my people, my beautiful people, with energy, dignity, and grace. Thank you so much.
I don't know if I let it go for another day. Let me stop by saying that nothing, nothing, nothing means more than the truth. And the truth is that I realize love is fading from your eyes. Don't know how it came to this, but we gon' get it fixed tonight. 'Cause nothing, nothing, nothing is worth losing you.
Janet,
that's my girl.
Give up music as long as it wants me to be around. I mean, I love music too much. It's too much a part of my life, my soul. I'll start a new project at the end of this year, possibly the beginning of sometime in the new year of creating going back into the studio and creating new music. I always write what's going on in my life at that moment, and I'm not at that point just yet. I'm not getting ready to go into the studio, so that's how I normally do it, and I reflect and figure out the space, try to be in the now, so that's what I wind up writing about. That's how I base the majority of my ideas, my concepts. So we'll see where I am at that very moment, that space, when I get ready to create music and to create each concept for each song. Lyrically speaking,
what's in store for you right now? What's next for you? Because you've done so many things. We're all looking for that exciting album to come out and that move and your dance and everything.
Well, I've been kind of putting the pieces of the puzzle together for recording, and just the beginning stages, putting it all together and deciding the mood, the direction, the energy.